In this video, we will see how to design a NAND gate using Cadence Virtuoso software. So, we will first take 5 grounds because in this circuit we need 5 grounds by going to create instance. Then, we will create PMOS and NMOS. So, go to library. So click on browse, go to library and choose GPDK library and then click on NMOS 1 volt and place it on the circuit. So we need to take the symbol. We need to click on the symbol. So first I will click on zoom to fit so that the area is clearly visible. So create instance, then browse, then click on symbol. So this will place the symbol of NMOS. We will need 2 NMOS to design a CMOS NAND gate. So now I will make the connections. So for NAND gate, the 2 NMOS are connected in parallel. The NMOS transistors are connected in parallel. To create connection, go to thin wire and then just join the points. Sorry, to create a NAND gate, we need to have 2 NMOS in series. So we will create the connections. So go to create thin line segment and we will join them using a thin wire. So the 2 NMOS are now joined. Now we will take 2 PMOS and the 2 PMOS will be in parallel connections. Again join, create connections between them using a thin wire. So these PMOS connections are also done. Again click on zoom to fit so that workspace is clearly visible. So we will now create connection between PMOS and NMOS. They will be provided a common input. So go to create instance and select analog lib library, then go to vpulse. So we will create 2 pulse voltages as input, 2 pulse voltage sources as input. So these will be the 2 inputs of your NAND gate. This is the first input and this is the second input. Now we will connect ground also. Both the voltage sources have to be grounded. First press the escape button of your keyboard. We will connect a ground to the NMOS as well. So the ground connections are made. Now we will provide the DC voltage source. So go to create instance. Click VDC. So click on symbol and place the DC voltage source here. Rotate it by using the R key. Rotate it by using the R key on your keyboard. So we will create the connections. We will take one ground also and ground the voltage source. Rotate the ground also for simplicity of the connection. So the connections are now made. Now all the input connections are now made. Now we will have to do the output connections. So we will take a capacitor for the output connection. Connect the capacitor and connect a ground also. So this capacitor will act as the load. Now we will set the values. So I am taking the voltage source as 1.8 volt, and click apply. Taking the period as 10 nanosecond and the pulse width as 5 nanosecond with 50% duty cycle. Click apply. Second voltage source of also of 1.8 volt, but now I am taking period 20 nanosecond and pulse width as 5 nanosecond. We will set the value for DC source as well. It will be equal to 1.8 volt. We will set the value of capacitor as well, 1 femtofarad. Click apply and OK. So all the connections are done. Click on check and save. So it is not giving any error, means our design is correct. Launch ADL, launch transient analysis. So do the transient analysis and select the outputs. All the outputs are selected. Click on check run. It will display the voltages. Output waveforms are displayed. So we can verify the NAND logic as well. We can also choose NAT highlighting as well. So thank you. Please like and share the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.